Hey, what's up, guys? It's Icarus here. Back in VR, I know I've been away for a while. Things has just slowly getting better and better every single day. So, why am I in VR and not in fursuit? Because it's an easier method for me to actually come out and do these videos for you guys. I literally can't always be in fursuit because my job is taxing and blah, 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 blah. So this is a nice little way to actually start doing videos for you guys, maybe on a regular. It's not, my life is not back on track, so I could do these videos like every week or every so often. So I'm going to do the best I can possibly do to give you some content. But for now, I'm in VR chat. It's a little bit easier for me to do these things, so I hope you enjoy, and let's get on with the video. What happens in the first week of July? Anthrocon, right? And Anthrocon would have happened in person if it wasn't for this global pandemic. We all know this global pandemic took away our fun, but the AV team and the con staff, they actually really prepared some actually great content for us over on YouTube and over on VR chat. There's worlds that, like, other furry conventions, like Fur Reality and something that just passed, I totally forgot, I think it's like Furry Luma or some. Even though that world is not there, it's literally like you can see videos of people going to it and everything. So VR chat is an actually great experience for the con experience. Anthrocon just passed. They just had their little virtual event, which they went above and beyond to do. They was fully vaccinated, people had live shows, people had like pre-recorded shows. It was actually really good to see. And they brought Pittsburgh inside this virtual reality. Like, not VR chat, but like, you know, their streams and stuff like that. And I actually really love the fact that like they did all of that. So I congratulate them and I thank them for what they've done. With that being said, I miss Anthrocon. You miss Anthrocon. A lot of people probably misses Anthrocon and probably misses being there at Anthrocon. So I was at work and I was just sad because, like, hey, I can't even watch this. I have to wait until the live stream is done and then I can watch it. So I got to thinking while I was managing a retail floor, I was just in my head. I wasn't even really thinking about the customers. I was just like in my head thinking about Anthrocon. Because the day that Anthrocon Live, or I'm just say it that, Anthrocon Online actually happened, was the day that I would have arrived at Anthrocon itself, would have arrived at Pittsburgh, would have got my registration and everything like that. I was a little bit in a stickler, like I was in my feelings. I really didn't want to be at work. I really wanted to be outside with fursuiting in the hot weather, just cruising and having fun with you fellow furries. But things happened. I couldn't do it, and my thoughts just got the better of me. So this video here is to tell you three stories of some of my best experiences at this convention at Anthrocon. And I I got the funny ones. I tried to pick out, like, it was like a lot of stories to tell, but I actually wanted the top three because I didn't want to make this video super long or super short with telling just one. So without further ado, here's one of my favorite stories. So this first story is actually near and dear to my heart. It's dealing with one of my best friends, and he's been there for 13 years now. I didn't meet him in a furry fandom. He's actually one of my closest friends in real life. We met in high school, and ever since then, we just sprouted a friendship to a brotherhood, and I call him my brother. I don't even call him my best friend anymore, because we've been past that. I can tell him things, he could tell me things, and that is just that friendship. Me and him, we usually bring a lot of people. When I say a lot, like 3, 4, 5 people. That may not be a lot, but with our group, That's a lot. That's a lot of heads to keep track of. Not because they're untrackable, it's because we know each other. Let's just say that. We know every single one of us. So 2019 was the day that we decided it was just going to be me and my best friend. Let's call him AJ. AJ, something you got to know about AJ. He is the coolest person you ever met. AJ can talk his way out of so many things because he's smooth, buttery, Mario Lopez looking ass dude. So that's actually a joke from high school. No one would get it, but he looks just like Mario Lopez. I'm not kidding you. He started coming to furry cons with me. He's not a furry. He's just adjacent. And that's funny because that's his actual fursona name that I created for him. He's a hyena with a robotic leg, robotic arm. My fault. Sorry. But the funny thing is, me and him, and I'm gonna call her Dawn. She's gonna hate the fact that I called her Dawn, but I'm gonna call her Dawn. We just got done suiting. I forgot what day it was. I think it was Saturday night. It was definitely Saturday night. We got done suiting, and we went back to the hotel, and we got desuited. We took off our suits. We're getting ready to eat. I'm super hungry. Like, I am starving at this point. It's around, I won't say nighttime. It's around probably 7, 8, around that time. We go trying to get something to eat. But we're still in the hotel. Mind you, I'm still desuiting. Desuiting takes it's harder to put the suit on than to take it off, but I am tired, I am hot, I'm trying to catch my breath, I'm trying to get like this AC going on. So I'm trying to relax. I seen him walking to the door. AJ doesn't say much when he feels like agitated or anything. So I thought he was a little agitated. I thought he was really hungry, like I was. I was starving. We was all kind of like hungry. So I thought that was the case. I know his body language, so I was trying to hurry up. And then he pulls out his phone, and I'm wondering, okay, so he's really angry, like he's really hungry. He pulls up his phone, he's texting people, whatnot. This man, from the deepest corner of the room, yells, and I mean yells this, "I got a call." That in itself was crazy. I was like, I never seen him do this. I know him for the life of me. I know he yells. I know he does some stupid stuff. It wasn't until he did the most obvious thing imaginable. He did this. He put his hands on his waist, leaned over, and winked. At that point, I looked at Dawn. Dawn looked at me. We looked at him. He looked at us.
Well, he looks at me, and I look at him. And he looks at me, and I look at him. And he looks at me, and I look at him.
And then he left the room to leave me and Dawn by ourselves. She looks at me. She looks into my eyes and said, "You know, if you wanted it so badly, why didn't you just ask?" We both started laughing so hard. This started a night of
passionate fornication.
I'll just call it that. It was a night of passion. And it was hilarious. I would say this. If there's a way that you can have a passionate night and also laugh while you're doing it, that's someone to keep. That's my opinion. That's someone to keep. In mid-coitus, Dawn literally looks him into my eyes, into my sweating, beating eyes. I'm like sweating all like just just it just looked wrong. I probably had like the old grin, the whole face going on. She looks at me and she's just like, "Hey, aren't we supposed to get food?" I screamed on the top of my lungs, "Yes! Yes! We're supposed to get food! But now we're doing this!" And she's laughing at me because I'm screaming at the top of my lungs. She's the calmest person I ever met in this situation. And the thing that gets me is she still talks to me to this day, and I still get on her about this. In the middle of it, I'm so close, and I think this is what killed it for me, was this single, what was his name again? Your friend? We gotta meet him. In the midst of it, I stopped, and I said, "Is that what you're really worried about right now?" She started crying, and I mean, not crying, but like, she started laughing so hard, which made me laugh so hard, and it just kept on going afterward. And then when we finally washed up and everything, we actually left. He was in the lobby, AJ was in the lobby just running around. He was just like, "Yo, I think I got a burger without you, I'm sorry."
You what?
This whole thing started because we wanted food, and you want to go eat without us? I still to this day hold it over against him that he ate a burger without us, while he was the one who initiated the mid-coitus. Like, are you serious? He is the best and worst wingman alive. I would say that. I will never let him live it down. I know it didn't have a punchline, it didn't have anything, it was just one of the funniest stories I ever had. And the next one, this is back in 2017, Anthrocon. This one was hilarious. AJ could not come this time. It was a serious accident, he actually broke his leg at that time, so he really couldn't come. So I brought four of my closest friends, and they all came with me. This would have been AJ's third time going, but again, he broke his leg, he couldn't come. It's me, then there's Flash, Nathaniel Slippery Upper Crust the Third, but I'm gonna just call him Slippy. We had Joker, and then we have Amethyst, which she does have a YouTube channel somewhere out there, which I'm gonna link in the description below. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. I'm tired. I wanna go to bed. There's nothing gonna happen for me for the rest of the night. Me and Amethyst, since we couldn't find our friends in the rave, we literally left back to the hotel. When we got to the Homewood Suites, we got upstairs, rested, because if you ever got a suite, it's like literally a living room, kitchen, and then your room. I sat on the living room couch. Our door is closed. I don't remember if we closed it or not. I don't know. I sat down on the couch. I'm ready to knock out. I don't know if Flash is in there. I don't know if he's dressing or anything like that. I don't know if he's taking a shower or just got out of the shower. I don't know. I sit on the couch. Nice and tuckered out. Nice. I'm about to fall asleep. Amethyst axes me. She was like, "Hey, Icarus, why are you not in the bed?" I said, "Listen, I don't know. I'm just so tired. I could just knock out here. I don't care where I sleep." She knocks on the door. No answer, actually. Knocks on it again. Again, no answer. So my thoughts is, someone's sleeping there. Flash is asleep. She kicks the door down. And I'm like, what are you doing? Woke me up instantly. What are you doing? And then that's when hell started breaking loose in my hotel room. I didn't know what the hell was going on. I woke up, went back to sleep. Like literally, like not physically, but like my soul exited my body and then came back. He was like, you're too tired for this. You do not need to be awake. Just let me go. And that's what happened. All I heard was screaming about who should get the bed. And I'm wondering, it was like, yo, it's okay. I could just knock out on the couch. I don't really care. I'm so tired. And plus, we got to pack up for tomorrow. That's fine. Flash isn't the type of person to argue back. So, knowing Flash, he was just sitting there, like, just hearing her bombardment of arguments. And he come out the room. He looks at me. He says, dude, this new episode of Attack on Titan was actually really good, and now it's ruined. I sat there, he's like, you didn't hear the door knock? You did not hear the door knock because you was watching what? Attack on Titan?
You what?
I'm in bed. Then my phone starts bleeping. It starts going off. And this is where the funniest part of that night happens. I looked at my phone. I see I got text messages from Joker. He sends me a picture. And this picture had me worried a little bit. This picture was a microwave with Wendy's nuggets in them. Now you're wondering, why is that weird? Why is that weird? That microwave looked like it exploded. I swear to God, whoa, I swear to everything that is holy, that microwave was just disgusting. I wish I could find that picture again. I wish I could find that picture. That picture had me crying. I was laughing so hard. My tiredness has literally gone away for like a good 2 minutes of me just crying laughing. Everyone is wondering what the hell is up with Icarus. He is crying like no tomorrow, full burst laughing. Sunday, we meet up. We got a, like, the hotel kicks us out because, hey, checkout time. They kick us out. We go to meet Joker and Slippy. We sit there. Joker has this face. I kid you not, he has this face. He is the king of making faces. But this face is just one of those. He's like, I give up on life. I give up on everything that is adjacent to life. Those nuggets gave him the illest stomach ache, which turned into the nastiest shit imaginable. And now the third story. The third story is a little short and a little it's really fun. Back in 2019, going back 2 years ago, where the first story took place. This is the same night after the mid-coitus. Alright? I went to the rave, and I had a particular outfit on. I wanted to look like Jeff Hardy mixed with Eddie Murphy, I guess. I don't know. I just picked the name. AJ can't dance. He'll tell you that himself. He can't dance. I'm the dancer of the two, and I don't even dance that well. But we're dancing, and I don't know if you guys know of the Millie Rock. Y'all should, because it's just out there. It's this dance. And you see how I Millie Rock, and it's nice and soft, right? You could go a little harder with bops to it. That a Millie Rock is a simple, easy dance. Never have I ever seen a Millie Rock try to cut somebody's head off. My friend, AJ, my brother, his Millie Rock, this thing, which is supposed to go nice and soft, was like blades from a samurai. I had to warn people to move out the way until they made a circle around him. He's doing a Millie Rock like he's about to smack the hand of God into people. Nice and pristine, like a nice blade cutting through butter. Then the other one comes in with the hand of God, open palmed, and smacks somebody's soul. It got to the point where people was around him, cheering him on, and he didn't even know it. So I took that opportunity to do the Millie Rock with him. So we was doing it inside the middle of a thing, but in the middle of the circle, he's doing it and I'm dodging it. So it looked like it looked as if we planned this, but it was not. I didn't want nobody else to get smacked with the hand of God. I know how that felt like. We spar. He does boxing, I do martial arts. We spar like crazy. I know how heavy those hands are. I knew his movements, so I'm dodging him, dodging all of him, and I'm doing it nice and soft. And it got to the point where he was like, hey, do your dance moves. He moves away from the circle. I'm the only one in a circle. Knowing me, I don't know if there's a video out there. I've been trying to find this video so hard. I do a little breakdancing. My shoe goes flying off. So I do this breakdancing move that I literally kick my foot up in the air and I stay there for a minute. I'm standing on my hands in a particular fashion. It looks like I'm breaking my neck. My shoe flew the fuck off. And if you know the rave, you know it's super dark. Super dark. You literally can't see it except for the blaring lights. My white shoe flew up and then down. Don't know where. I stood up. I was like, yo, listen, I'm screaming this because no one can hear me over the music. I'm screaming, hey, has anyone seen a white shoe? And then I heard it. Of an audible. As soon as the beat dropped, that's when I heard it. It was hilarious. Thank goodness AJ, he followed the trajectory of my shoe, said sorry to the person who got executed with a size 9 Nike shoe, and then ran through the crowd to get it, and then came back and said, yo, I got your shoe, let's get out of here. That was the last thing I did that night. We got back to the hotel and we knocked out, and that was it. So guys, that was all three stories. This is something I just wanted to do. I haven't been on YouTube so much. I know I've been away. Things are looking a little bit brighter, so I'm happy to say that. I've been dealing with a lot of stuff, work, personal, all of that. But I'm back, hopefully. But I'm so glad that y'all came to check me out. I'm still alive, I'm still kicking. So with that being said, I hope you have a good one. This is Icarus. I'm out.